For this video, I'll be sharing with you 5 rules on subject and verb agreement. This is part 2 of my video. Again, it's so easy. All you have to do is to listen and watch this video. Number 1 rule, words joined to a subject by with, together with, in addition to, and including, do not affect the verb. Now let's have this sentence. The vendor, together with his friends, sells mangoes. The tip is, hanapin natin ang subject. And for this sentence, ano yung subject natin? Vendor. Now, ang vendor ay nasa singular form. Gumamit pa din tayo ng mga salita na included dun sa rule natin? Yes, gumamit tayo. And we use the words together with. Now, after those words, ano yung kasunod? His friends. At ang friends ay nasa plural form because ito ay may S. Now, pumunta naman tayo dun sa verb natin. Ano napapansin ninyo? It's still in singular form kasi ang singular form of the verb ay may S. Bakit tayo gumamit ng singular form of the verb? Again, let's go back to the rule. Kahit na ano paman ang kasunod sa mga words na with, together with, in addition to, and including, it may be singular or plural form, the verb will not affect because always the verb will agree to its subject. And for this sentence, the subject is the vendor, which is in singular form. Therefore, we should use singular form of the verb. Again, our sentence, the vendor, together with his friends, sells mangoes. Number 2 rule, nouns plural in form but singular in meaning tie with singular verb. Ito na yung sinasabi natin na mga special nouns. Ito na yung mga may S sa dulo pero ang kahulugan niya ay singular pa rin. Now, let's take a look to these sentences. Number 1, mathematics is my favorite subject. Ano yung verb na ginamit ko? Is. At ang is ay singular form. Why did I use is? It is because mathematics, which is the subject sa sentence, ay isang example ng special noun. And again, special noun, plural in form, but singular in meaning. Now, let's take a look to the sentence number 2. Dramatics is fascinating. Now, ano yung verb na ginamit ko? Is. At ang is ay nasa singular form. Now, why did I use it? It is because our subject is an example of special noun. Again, special noun, plural in form, but singular in meaning. Number 3 rule, a collective noun ties either with a singular or plural verb, depending on whether the group is taught as a whole or as individuals. Ano ba itong collective nouns? So, ito yung mga halimbawa ng nouns na in a group. Tinitingnan natin sila na in a group. Examples, class, jury, audience, or crowd. So, those are examples of collective noun. Now, let's go through these examples na mga sentences. Number 1, our class sings very well. Number 2, our class do not agree on the song for the program. Ano yung pagkakaiba ng dalawang sentences? Number 1, nag-taught yung group na class as isa, as one, as a whole. That's why ginamit ang verb na singular. Kasi as one ang class, ang taught ng class sa sentence number 1. So, isa lang siya. Now, sentence number 2, ano yung verb na ginamit? Do not agree. Do not agree. It's a plural form of the verb. Bakit natin ginamit yung plural form of the verb? It is because yung thought ng class ng collective noun sa sentence na to ay individual. So, it means hindi sila as one na nag-agree, as a class na nag-agree sa pinili na kanta. So, it means it is being taught as individuals, kung ilan man yung pupils or ilan man yung estudyante dun sa class. So, hindi 100% agreed sa kung ano man yung song na gusto nila for the program. That's why, yung verb na ginamit for the sentence number 2 ay plural form of the verb. It is because the collective noun, yung thought ng collective noun na ginamit sa sentence number 2 ay as individuals. So, marami. Number 4 rule, if two subjects are joined by or, either, or, neither, nor, the verb agrees with the subject near it. For example, if you have this sentence, either the book or computers have the data. Now, ano yung verb na ginamit natin in today's sentence? Have. At ang have ay nasa plural form. Now, why did we use the plural form of the verb? It is because, again, ano yung subject na malapit sa verb? Computers. At ang computers ay nasa plural form. Now, going back to our rule, the verb agrees with the subject near it. Since the subject is in plural form, therefore, we must use plural form of the verb. Another example, neither your friends nor your neighbor completes the task. Now, ano yung verb na ginamit natin? Completes. Why did we use completes and it is in singular form? Because yung subject na malapit sa verb ay singular form. And again, the rule says the verb agrees with the subject near it. And sa sentence na ito, the subject na malapit sa verb ay nasa singular form. Number 5 rule, a compound subject joined by and ties with a plural verb, except when the subjects refer to the same person or thing. Let's take a look to these sentences. Number 1, my English instructor and advisor is absent. Ano yung verb na ginamit sa sentence? Is. At ang is ay nasa singular form of the verb. Why did we use the singular form of the verb? It is because ang advisor niya at ang English instructor niya ay iisang tao. So, it refers to the same person. That's why we use the singular form of the verb. Now, for the second sentence, my English instructor and my advisor are absent. What did we use na verb dito sa sentence? Are. And are is nasa plural form. And why did we use the plural form of the verb? It is because ibang tao yung English instructor niya and yung advisor. That's why it refers to two persons. And because of that, we use the plural form of the verb. Now, it's time for some exercises and for you to answer this. Number 1, the machine with all its parts sells for 500 pesos. Number 2, my mother and advisor sings very well. Number 3, athletics are my brother's sport. Number 4, either the santan or roses blooms every day. Number 5, The audience claps to his performance. That's it, kids! I hope this video could help you, and again, thank you for watching and see you on my next video. Bye, kids!